should be all set now. So if you have a question for Coach, please let us know in the chat. And we'll get started with Ted Colfin from the Detroit News.
A quick trigger finger. It's like regular season form or something. Why Alex Tange? What did he bring to the table, Jeff?
Well, when I went into this process to find an assistant coach, first off, I talked to a number of really good people and really good coaches. Every coach in the NHL is a good coach. Guys that have had experience in this league are really good coaches. But I wanted to find somebody unique if I could, and unique especially from the offensive side of the puck. Somebody who thought the game from a little different perspective. A lot of coaches who are maybe offensive coaches are offensive because they make that part of the game important, and that's not necessarily what I was looking for. I wanted somebody who really thought it offensively in somewhat unique ways, and ultimately Alex was a great fit for us because of that. He's got offensive beliefs based on his playing career, his playing experience, his coaching experience, but also just the way his mind thinks of hockey and sees spatial situations and how to create outnumbered situations and more on a micro level as much as on a macro level. And I think one of his greatest strengths is going to be helping our individual players get better at within their structure, within our structure, to help them find ways to ultimately be more offensive. And so that was something I was really looking for, something I think Alex brings to the table. He thinks offense because that's the way that he looks at it, not necessarily because he went to a coaching clinic. And that was something that was really important to me.
Hey, Jeff, was there like one thing that he said or did that kind of like, oh, wow, that's interesting. Okay. I mean, maybe a theory or belief that he has that kind of like, impressed you or something like that?
Not necessarily. And honestly, I don't, hockey isn't as much about schematics as it is about probably the details within the systems. It's a very fluid game. So to think that you're going to out schematic another team, I think is a false narrative. That's football. Hockey is again more of the little details within the systems. Most teams play somewhat similar systems, certainly in the power play. Everybody in the league pretty much has real similar look at the way that they attack it, and then it's trying to help those guys within that structure get better. And as we went through my conversations with Alex, and I didn't know him prior. I mean, I had met him once or twice prior to this, but really didn't know him prior to this. And as we went through the process of it, we spoke about a lot of our players and a lot of little different situations. And I just was really impressed with the little things that he said to me that he felt this player could, he could help this player find more space in this situation that way, and he could help this player find more space in this situation that way. And really, that's what it comes down to, creating space and creating outnumbered situations within a structure. And that's where I was impressed.
Hey, last one. So other than Danny leaving, the rest of the staff stays the same then?
Correct. Yep, the rest of the staff stays the same.
Just want to make sure. Hey, thanks for this, Jeff.
Yep, absolutely.
Next, we'll go to Helene St. James from the Detroit Free Press.
Hi, Jeff. One thing that jumps out looking at Alex's resume is how well the Wild performed on the power play. And I remember you and Steve talking at the end of the season about, that's among the areas that needed the most improvement. What in your conversation with him did he kind of intimate that how he could help you guys on the power play?
Yeah, well, that will certainly be one of his responsibilities. And ultimately, for us to be better on the power play, we all have to be better. Alex, who will be oversee it, and our players. And I've talked to all our players about the similar thing, whether it's guys coming in or whether it's guys that have been on it. We all collectively have to take responsibility with it. Again, for me, and I think sometimes when you look at coaches and you look at what their power play percentages are of the groups that they've coached, that can be a little misleading at times, because a lot of it's based on talent that team has. I want to dig a little deeper. And again, when we dug a little deeper, I'm very confident that Alex can put a structure together, can have a foundation of a power play, But to me, it was more than that. And where I'm really confident that Alex can help our guys, again, is in those individual situations on the power play. If a guy plays a net front, let's say Adam Murray played the bumper for us. Adam Murray played the bumper. He can help Adam through video, through little drills, through his mindset, through the way that he sees the game, find ways to get open more. And ultimately, that's a critical thing on the power play. He can help our flankers, I believe, find ways to evaluate and scan and know the best options that are coming that the player has available to him. Find ways with our net front players to be a little bit more dangerous. And that's where I thought Alex was pretty unique because of the fact that the way that he sees hockey and because he was a really cerebral offensive player himself and can glean those experience to our players as he goes through the process with us.
And just while I have you, Jeff, Dylan Larkin, is he able to start? Has he started training? Like, kind of where is he at with his recovery?
He hasn't started training yet, but I think he's along the timeline that we expected. And, you know, I don't know the exact, I'd have to sit down with my training staff and to tell you the exact date today, but he's along the timeline that we expected within his recovery.
And same with Tyler Bertuzzi or?
Yeah, Tyler, Tyler's probably been able to do a little bit more lately. And I think he's getting to the stage where he can start to get out of just pure rehab and get into training, strength training, trying to build his body back up. So I've seen both of them. Both of them are in good spirits, and both of them, I think, are headed in the right direction in terms of the recovery.
Thanks, Jeff.
Yep.
Next, we're going to Max Waldman from The Athletic.
Hey, Jeff, you mentioned him being a cerebral player. How much has it helped to not just have played at a high level in the league, but also fairly recently? I think 5-6 years ago, he was still in the league. Like, what advantage does that give him?
You know, when I coached in Grand Rapids, Chris Chelios helped us out there, and one of the things I always thought about there was that Chris thought like a player still, and in a good way. And you know, I think as a coaching, when you coach a long time, you start thinking like a coach, and that there's nothing wrong with that. That's a positive thing. But I think having played recently will help Alex. You know, he still can look at it from the mindset of the player, because it's really fresh. It's fresh. It's not that long ago that he played. He played in different eras, really in the NHL, because he played a long time, and he's played into an era that was closer to what this is today. I was also really impressed with the fact that for a guy who had a really successful career, he chose to get out of us, you know, he started a pretty successful career in TV and chose to get out of that and go to Iowa as an assistant coach with the Iowa Wild. Like, that to me spoke volumes of his commitment to wanting to be a coach. So I think, he showed a great commitment to want to be a coach, but he also has played recently and has, certainly has that mindset of what the players are going
And then to. You mentioned no other changes to the staff. Are you making another hire, or are you guys done now on the staff?
No, we're done with our stuff.
Thank you.
Yep.
Our last question will come from Ansar Khan from MLive.
Yeah, hi, Jeff. Is there one particular area of the power play that you need to see improvement in, whether it's entries or retrievals or just shot mentality, or just a combination of everything?
Yeah, I think when our power play is at the percentage it's at, I think it's a combination of everything. You know, I think it starts with winning more faceoffs. We didn't win faceoffs to the degree that we had won in the past, and our power play faceoff percentage wasn't good enough. And I think, you know, power play to a large degree, success a lot of times can come off that opening draw. So I would start there, but then I would start with just our decision-making once we're in zone and set up. After we've won the face-off, and then our ability to get into the zone. And so I don't know that it's one thing at all. I think it's just collectively we need to be better. And I think a large part of that, too, is confidence. You know, one of the things that I'm going to ask Alex to do is watch all our players, having gone through their past history in the power play, and try to work really hard to get the right pieces in the right spots. I think that's a critical part of a good power play, is getting the right pieces in the right spots. And so, do we have the guys in their right spots? Is there a guy we've had on the net front that maybe he's better on the flank or maybe better in the bumper. And those are all the things we have to look at. Part of that will depend on what our team looks like when September rolls around. There's obviously lots that are going to happen between now and then. So, you know, to me, this was step one, hiring a coach who I think has an opportunity to make the individual players on the power play better. And that was probably the most critical thing in terms of, I think Alex is going to bring a lot more to the table than just that, but that was one of the critical things to hiring a power play guy was somebody who can make our individual players better.
And just a follow-up on the injured players, Larkin and Bertuzzi, are you expecting them to be ready for camp? Or do you know for sure yet? Or?
Well, you know, in this business, you never know for sure, Ansar. And so I certainly wouldn't say today that I know anything for sure. We expect both of their recoveries to be along a timeline that they're ready for camp. And whether that happens, it doesn't happen, honestly, you just never know. And that's true of all our players. You never know what's going to happen from now until September. But we anticipate their timelines being to a spot to where they'd be ready for camp.
Thanks, Jeff.
Yep.
All right, thanks, everyone. Those are all the questions we had for Coach Blashill. We're going to move everyone over into the waiting room now while we get Alex Tanguay in the call. So please hang tight, and we'll bring everyone back into the Zoom here shortly.